understand what I'm saying? Okay, well, you still seem a little bit alarmed, unfortunately. I'm so sorry. It's ill, don't you think? I mean, seeing as you're working with all these things, didn't you think that we'd come by one day? I mean, you're practically begging us to come down here, right? No, we're not here to do any harm, I promise. No. We're actually only here to, give you a bit of a checkup, essentially. Just to, see how far you're getting on and, you know, taking some samples. But nothing scary, I promise. Okay, let me just give you this back. Just for future reference, we don't actually look like this. The reason why your memories might be a little bit distorted is because we use different tools to drain your memories when you have met us. And sometimes it's very successful, but other times, well, you seem to only remember little bits and pieces, and we're only trying to help, really. So, I mean, if we wanted to take over this planet, we would have a long time ago, so it's like, you know. We're actually going to have to do the same to you today, I'm afraid, but I'm sure you'll be fine. I mean, other than feeling like you've had a weird dream, it shouldn't really make a big difference. So, let me show you what we'll be doing. We're going to be opening up your head, but not in a very scary, gory way. We're just going to manifest the brain out of your mind. Okay, out of your skull, basically. And we're going to give it a little wash, a little scrub, a little rinse, okay? We actually have these lovely tools that we use for that. They are very, very soft. And they should essentially just feel like a little scalp massage, really. So, nothing dangerous, nothing scary, okay? And what we do at the same time, actually, we take out bad memories at the same time. So, these are human memories in here, okay? They look very fuzzy because we have coated them with a protection barrier, okay? So, occasionally, we actually cover them with a fuzzy barrier to give back to you because some bad experiences lead to a lesson, right? So we want to prevent you from going through a similar thing again. So we just let you handle it differently in future, so to say. Mm-hmm. What doesn't kill you? Yeah, okay. So, yeah, you can hold on to these if you'd like while we perform the exams and stuff. Yeah. We're also going to measure you a little bit. Just give you an overall checkup, like I mentioned. Now, there are some things that we've found along our journeys throughout different times where we would also like to ask you for advice. Okay, so, let's start with the first thing. This is quite big. We found this in the 1990s. Were you alive then? Well, it's this plastic thingy, and it has creatures on them. And now, we've seen these a lot throughout our travels, but we've only ever seen them on your screens, not in real life. Now, what could this mean? Are they actual animals? Pokemon? Okay. I mean, some of these somewhat resemble animals, I suppose, like a meow looking like a cat, or a polywell looking like a frog. Does that make sense? Okay. So it says here, there are exactly 150, is that correct? Oh, so many more nowadays. Do they multiply? I see. Interesting. It says here whoever this jar belonged to, they put little ticking off thingies in the boxes, but some of them are not caught. It seems like the ones that haven't been caught yet are called Raiden, Magma, Moltres, Amistar, Porygon, Weezing, Dragonite, and Mewtwo. Any of those ring a bell? Okay, so you say that this is a pop culture thing, so we don't need to add this to our animal index. I see. Okay, perfect. Thank you. Well, yes, if you'd like to, you can keep this. I mean, it is a bit filthy. I don't think it has been stored very well. Maybe some water damage. Yeah, okay, here. Just pop this to the side. Okay. Another thing that we found was this. Now, we first thought that it was a device from us that we'd left in a different timeline, but this looks like maybe a piece of jewelry. Although, I know you humans can't really carry that much weight. So, is this jewelry? No. Oh, well, it has these pretty flowers on them and little stones that sparkle in the light. So I figured maybe this would be something to apply to a headpiece or something. Oh, it's an ornament. Where would you put this? Right. You put them on trees. Any tree? Oh, I've heard of those. Right. No, we don't get those where I come from. No, no. The temperature is rather harsh, so your life forms wouldn't really find it that easy to exist where we are. So, we have similar things, but on the other hand, they couldn't survive here either because your temperature changes are quite rapid, aren't they? Well then. So, I suppose you could keep this as well, really, if you'd like, since we will not be needing this. Mm-hmm. Well, if you don't like it, you can just give it to somebody else. Okay. Good. So, I think that's it for now. If we find more things, we'll just come back and ask again. But for now, let's just prepare your brain so that you can forget everything later on. Okay? I'm gonna give it a bit of a wash. You will not forget things immediately. This will happen over the time that you sleep, which is also why we will be giving you a little hypnosis treatment towards the end. Yes. Again, nothing scary, just some little hand movements and sounds to help you fall back to sleep. Mm-hmm. We can also program a nice dream into there if you'd like, something to maybe cover up the events from now. Okay. Well, you see, the reason we can't keep you thinking like this is because, well, I mean, I suppose we could, because, I mean, you've got all this going on. But, well, we'd rather you just, we'd rather just have you live your life like you were, you know? It makes things a lot easier for all of us. So, okay. So we are just going to take these and very gently cover your face, like so. Just covering you so that we can manifest the brain right here. still for me. Manifested right here. Don't be afraid. This will not cause you to feel any pain, and it will also not change anything about your prior knowledge about things. Good. So first things first, I would like to go in and give you a bit of a clean with this special liquid. Take a few pumps. There we go. And then as we gently dab the brush in here, going to rid you of the recent bad thoughts and worries. And in every little corner, a tiny little piece here. Now, after we've done that, what we will be doing next is we are going to actually apply a scrub, okay? So, to mix up multiple components. Seeds. Okay, let's just draw on a thick base and then we can work that in with our fingers. Good. So. Very, very good. Getting into each and every corner. You just give your brain a bit of a massage at the same time. going to loosen up any core memories that we need to maybe reshape to help you find things easier. Very good. And as a last step, we actually want to spray the brain a little bit with a very, very gentle solution, getting rid of the scrub and also just letting the water energy draw out anything that is still stuck. Okay? So for that, I'm going to use this right here. And push and push and push, push the brain back in and push, push, push and push. Very good. Okay, that should be taking effect in a very short time. Now, let me just list of things here that I had written down for you. May I borrow? Thanks. Okay. Okay. So far, we've removed that. Clean, scrub, and rinse. Already discussed the human. That's good. Okay. Right. So, would you mind if I did a little medical exam on you? Yeah. We're just going to inspect the skin, the eyes, nose, ears, and the mouth. Okay? Just your overall well-being before we continue. Okay? Alright. So, let's just have actually, let me use my little tool here. Okay. So we're just gonna have a little look see here. And see if we can actually spot something that might be concerning, although I don't think that we will find anything right now because it should be fine. Especially since we didn't do Checkup all too long ago, so that didn't be fair. Okay. Fantastic. Are you drinking enough water? Please do. That is very, very important, okay? Okay. And moving down slightly, looking at your neck area. I suppose we might be needing to get that area. Do you have any issues with heat or cold on your skin? Okay. Please do make sure that you always wear a good sun protection because your sun is very strong. It is a very, very big star. Okay, and I wouldn't want you to in any pain, right? Usually sun damage shows itself after around 15 to 20 years, but obviously if you want to sit outside in really hot weather, it's going to show effect immediately pretty much, so you just want to make sure that you are safe. Okay. Right, let's look at the crown of the head here. Okay. Would you say that you have any problems with your scalp, any tenderness, itchiness? anything at all. Okay, well, there are some very nice herbs that you can use from your planet. Just blend that together with a bit of oil and then rub that in before you wash your hair, okay? And also, obviously, buy a product that is suitable. Okay, good. Right. So your skin is looking okay. I would like to move on with the eyes next, okay? So if you could just look straight at my face, just focus on a middle point here, okay? I'm just going to check the peripheral vision, okay? I'm going to shine my light to the corners of your vision, okay? Or at least what I perceive to be your vision. Now, I'm going to do the same thing and you tell me when you can see the light. Good. Excellent. Good. Perfect. Wonderful. Excellent. Okay. Can you also, without moving your head, just keep it still, can you follow the light with your eyes? Just the eyes, okay? Right. Don't move your head. Okay, I'm going to bring this finger in, okay? Just to create a bit of a distraction, but I want you to follow the light only. Only the light. Only the light. Very good. Can be a little bit tricky at times, but just follow the light for me. Okay, now follow the finger, okay? Just the finger, not the light, just the finger. Very good. Okay, back to the light, follow the light only. Very good. Okay, excellent. Right. Now let's see if you can also do the next part. If you could focus on the center of my face, okay? I'm going to be moving either these fingers or these ones, okay? So, your left or your right, okay? You tell me which one is moving. Look at the center of my face. Good. This way around, up, down, down, up, down, up. Very good. Any trouble there? No? Good. Right. Let me just prod around the skin around your eye. Close your eyes for me. Okay. Just gonna gently prod the skin. And up here as well, around the eyes. Okay. No swelling. That is perfect. Okay. Let us move on to nose and mouth next, okay? Good. Okay. Have you recently had any trouble at all sensing any scents? Only when you have a cold. Okay. So, I have these three different scents here, which I would like you to distinguish. So, what does this smell like to you? Raspberry. Very, very good. Perfect. Let's pick the next one. What about this? Coconut, very good. And what about this one right here? What does this smell like? Apple, very, very good. Fantastic. Okay. Now let's just have a little look into your nose. Okay. Could we use this little tool again here? As well. Can you breathe in and out normally? Yep. Okay. Can you breathe in for me through the nose? And out through the mouth? Good. In through the nose again. And out through the mouth. Okay, fantastic. Okay. That is looking wonderful. Okay, so next we shall test your sense of taste. Okay, so for that, again, three different options that I have here. Just take these here. So, what does this taste like to you? Lemon. Yes, very good. Very bitter, I know. Next one, what does this one taste like? Cinnamon. Very good. And a third one. What does this one taste like? Blueberries. Very, very good. Excellent. Okay. Any trouble with the mouth at all, or with your teeth perhaps? Do you go to your mouth doctor regularly? Well, yes, the dentist, I suppose. Oh, okay. Well, the recommendation is, I believe, once every 6 months, depending on what your conditions are. So, do keep that in. Okay, let's have a little look inside your mouth. Say, ah. Good. Okay, let me see if everything is working properly. Can you stick your tongue to the roof of your mouth? Okay, and then to the right side. And the left side. And back down. And ah, again. Okay. Yeah, that's looking just fine. Perfect. Okay. Have that done. Then next we're going to do a little hearing test, okay? Or just checking on your ears. We have a little look with my light first. I'm going to take the smaller part of this tool this time. Okay, we need a smaller magnifying glass for this area, so we're just going to have a little look here. But so far that seems to look okay. I think maybe side. Let's see if that's all looking as it should. If it's the same on the other side as well. That's okay. Right. That is looking wonderful. Alright. So, the way I'm going to be testing your ears, okay, is I am going to be making some sounds around your ears, okay? And I would love it if you could tell me which ear you hear the sound in, okay? Your right ear or your left ear. Okay, so you need to close your eyes for this, okay? Just close them. Okay, good. And I'm going to be making some sounds like this. Left ear. Right ear. Very good. We're going to do that with this item. Left. Right. Left. Right. Left. Right. Very, very good. Now what about this sound here? one more. Left. Right. Left. Right. Very, very. Your face next. What do you say? Yeah, okay. So we have our last records of you back here. Okay. So I'm just gonna check and see if that is all still up to date. Okay. Going to measure your nose first. Good. Right, I'm also going to go with the width here. From your ear down to the chin. Other side as well, that is also correct. I'm going to measure from the lower lip down to the chin. And then the lower lip in general. Also going to measure in between the upper lip and the tip of the nose. Okay. Mm-hmm. Generally width of your face. Go with the length. Okay. Go across the forehead. Good. And then of the head going down to the eyebrows on both sides. Alright. Okay. So, I'm also going to measure the distance of your eyes here. And the distance from the eye going towards the temple on both sides. Yep. Measuring the eye itself. Mm-hmm. Very good, very good. That is also very accurate. Very good. Okay. So. Now, what we also want to do here is we want to take some samples with us. Okay? So, nothing drastic, of course. We just need some skin samples, hair samples, and a little bit of your saliva as well. Okay? Just to complete the entire checkup here. So, just open this up. The samples in there. Now, what I'm going to give to you is this little brush here. I need you to chew on it for a few seconds, and after you have chewed around on it, we will be putting that in the box for the saliva sample. We need for the skin samples is this here. I'm just gonna gently with some skin samples. It should take the very, very finest of samples on the very first outside layer of the skin. Just very gently. A little knot in here so that everything is secure. Apply that in there, and then I just need very few bits and pieces of your hair. Yeah? Okay. I'll make sure to cut on the inner area, okay? Not too much either. I need the little brush I gave you. Thanks. Pop that in there as well. Close this. Seal it. Excellent. So. Lovely. So, another thing that we have to take from you is something you actually weren't really aware of that you had it in the first place, which would be a head chip. We usually use this to figure out where you are, so that we can quickly find you and take samples or take whatever we need. So we're going to be taking that because we actually found a much simpler way to figure out where you are now, which doesn't involve poking something into your skin. Okay, so what I'm going to be doing here, I'm going to make a tiny little incision, okay, in your forehead. Okay, so we're just going to use this little dotting tool. It won't hurt. There we go. Okay, and that should just numb the area a little bit. We want to pull it out with this little tool here. So just hold still for me. So creating these movements will draw the chip out. They are all connected through magnets. So this will... There we go. Don't need that anymore. Let's just apply a little bit of healing gel. Should get you healed in about 5 seconds. Okay, just apply that to you. Okay. Very good. That is done. It shouldn't really create any difference in how you're feeling. We made sure that it would be so small that you don't even know. Okay, excellent. So, one more thing I would like to test is your capability to react on reflex testing. Okay, so if I were to tap this on your arm, okay, Can you feel that? Yeah? Okay. Yeah. Perfect. Mm-hmm. Let's try this up here. Collarbone. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Just below the chin as well. Good. Jaw. And you feel this as well, when I rub against the hand. Yeah. Okay, fantastic. Again, if you have very rapid temperature changes, it could be that your skin finds it difficult to acclimatize sometimes. So do make sure that you are very gentle with yourself, okay? That's very, very important. I know a lot of you tend to ignore the season and just rush through everything, and that is not okay, so I would very much like to remind you to be kind to yourself, be gentle, okay? Good. So, let me just write down some of the information that I've gathered so far. Okay. So, are there any questions that you have for me? Why was I speaking a different language at the beginning? That is a very good question. In actual fact, the reason why we thought you were speaking that language was because we received a very strange signal through space, and it was radio waves. But they came from a different time. Yes, almost 100 years ago. And one of the very first signals that we picked up, so we tried to locate that, learn that language, and then we just kind of learned all the languages surrounding that area and just hoped that you would be speaking that one. Mm-hmm. Yes. Well, at this point we've learned quite a few hundred languages, so I was sure that we would find one that you can use with us. No, the language on our home planet is completely different. Our throats are actually built very different, so I'm not quite sure that you could pronounce the vowels in the first place. Yeah. So. I mean, you could try. I suppose it takes a lot of practice. I mean, every language has their bits and pieces that, you know, people who speak other languages might find difficult. For example, the first language that we used when we came to you has the h sound, like Eichhörnchen, you know? And that's a little bit difficult for some. Although, speaking of, when you say the word cute, the between the C and the U, that's the sound that you want to make. Yeah. Okay, anyhow, let's see. We have done everything that we need. We have measured you. We have done the examination part. We have also discussed the human bits and pieces. Checking the skin, the mouth, the eyes, nose, and ears. We took some samples. So all that's left to do now, really, I suppose, would be the hypnosis for your sleep. Shall we program in a dream for you? We can totally do that, yeah. Well, let's see. Some recent favourites have been visiting a place you've never been to, trying out food that you've never tried, beating a good video game. What else? Let's see. Being able to decorate your place however you want it. Although sometimes that ended up being a little bit scary because I don't know what went wrong, but it turned into some sort of... Are you familiar with a game called The Backrooms? Well, anyway, it wasn't a good idea. So we had to pull them out of those dreams pretty quickly. Let's just give you a nice day with a type of weather that you love. and a wonderful hot beverage for you to drink while you are walking along somewhere in nature, and you hear the sounds of laughter in the background of people that you really like, and they are waiting for you to join them doing something fun. Also, it might serve as inspiration for something you might be doing in the future. Okay, so we've got that sorted. That is perfect. Right, so all I need you to do now is simply relax, okay? I'm going to be performing these gentle hand movements in front of your face to help you drift off. You're going to hear some whispers in the background. That is all part of the magic, okay? Perfect. If you ever need anything, just think of us, okay? And we will find you. You may not remember us, like last time and the time before, but we'll get to, you know, it'll be fine. So you just relax, okay? Just relax, relax, relax. Relax, 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 and drift off into a beautiful slumber. Good night, my friend. I will see you again.